Hello, my name is Tas Chuck. I'm an aerospace engine student, and at the same time, I'm a scaled model hobbyist. Today I will talk about one of my favorite models that I've built in these few years, and I will also briefly describe the process that I've gone through in building the model. The model we'll talk about today is this.
This is a 1-700 heavy cruiser which served the Imperial Japanese Navy in World War II, and it's called TONE. The model at the very start was split into various pieces, and I need to glue them together later on. But before I start working on the model, it is quite important to do some research about the ship, for instance, its paint scheme, weapons and equipment that were used. Most importantly is to look for some photos about the real ship, because they could give me a great details about how the actual ship should look like. I spent a good amount of time to collect a lot of historical photos about TONE, and I also pay attention to the details of the ship, for example, the position of the searchlight, fences, radio antenna, and etc. I used all sorts of equipment and tools to make models, and different tools will handle different tasks.
For example, the tweezers here to handle tiny stuff, pliers to bend aluminium tubes, a knife to cut plastic plates, and a standard cutter to cut plastic bits. These are all basically all the tools that I used.
Once I've started putting different parts together, I also modified some of the decorations on the model. The rough shape of the model can be seen after completing this step, and it gave me a very brief idea of the actual size of the model and the amount of extra customizations that I need to put on the model. The parts that are gold in color were in fact made by myself from scratch. This process was very time consuming and could be very frustrating, as the parts are so small. I also purchased some extra kits to put onto the model, like the AA guns and safety bolts, which can make the model to look more realistic. The next step was to put color onto the model, which I believe is the most exciting part, because after completing these steps, the model would come alive. I used airbrush to put colors onto the model because airbrush is really good in handling small stuff. The last step was to further refine the details, like strings, flag, seaplanes, and etc. And here comes a year's effort and a great sense of accomplishment. Thank you for watching, hope you guys enjoyed.